compensation, you see, all of this we define in Oracle. The basic component is called as elements. So element is any component of pay or compensation given to an employee. The compensation may be in the form of cash or non-cash components. Examples include salary, housing allowance, transport allowance, medical premium, bonus, vacation, leave, paid time off, car, housing, 401k, alimony, child support, taxes, social security payments, SDI, insurance, everything. Everything is compensation. Behind the compensation, from an Oracle perspective, we define these compensation as elements. So like a pay code, you can say. Everything will have a pay code. Salary will have a pay code. Bonus will have a pay code. HRA will have a pay code. Travel allowance will have a pay code. LTC will have a pay code. LTA will have a pay code. Annual vacation will have a pay code. Everything will have an element. The elements are grouped or classified as earning, deductions, employer charges, voluntary deductions, information, etc. Information type of element is used to capture non-cash benefits to an employee. It is also used for internal calculations during payroll.
Now, what is this example?
Information type means something that you have given to the employee, but you want to put it on record. You don't want to, you have not given him something cash. For example, you have given him a leased accommodation. Okay. House is owned by the company. Yeah. Rental is being paid by the company. But you are staying there.
Okay.
Or a car has been given to you. Car is owned by the company. Fuel, everything, maintenance is paid for by the company. You are only using it. So that could be information. Loan taken. You have taken some loan. Okay, loan has been disbursed through payables or through payroll. Now you are tracking how much amount is remaining. Every time you repay, you are reducing the amount. So that could be your information type of element. It is also used for internal calculations during payroll. Classification varies from country to country. That is from legislation to legislation. Elements can be recurring or non-recurring. Recurring means elements are entered once and paid in every paid period. So payroll is divided into different pay periods, monthly, weekly, bi-monthly, every 2 weeks, you know, like that. So every pay period is every pay period you process your payroll and pay the employees. Recurring elements, you only enter it once and they will be processed during every pay period.
Okay.
Non-recurring elements, on the other hand, have to be entered in each pay period. In every pay period, you have to enter it. Salary is the example of a recurring element. You enter it once every pay period, you will have to pay basic salary or salary. HRA, you have to pay in every pay period. But bonus, you don't pay in every pay period. Medical premium, you pay in every pay period. Deduction. But you deduct in every pay period, right? Overtime, you don't pay every time. You only pay overtime when the person has worked overtime.
Okay.
Same thing only. Priority for an element controls the order in which the elements are processed. Okay? So you have multiple elements here. Sometimes, you know, people have 300, 400 elements in a payroll. So all those, system needs to know in which order to process. So that processing order is controlled by the priority. Priority is assigned to a classification by range of numbers. So it can be 1 to 1000 or 1001 to 2000. Termination rule. Termination rule means what happens to the element when the employee leaves. You will be surprised to know there are a lot of companies who may be paying their employees even after they leave. One or two employees, they often escape or, you know, they fall through the crack. Company doesn't realize they have been paying him. So to prevent that, moment an employee resigns, you terminate. System will put an end date on the element. Last standard process. The last standard process means, suppose a person is resigning on 15th of June and your last payroll is 30th of June. So his final settlement will happen on 30th of June. So in that, till 30th of June, he will be paid, but his payment will be prorated to 15th of June.
So he'll pay only the 30th.
Correct. He'll be paid on 30th when the payroll is processed for everyone. Last standard earning date, that means the element end date will be 15th of June. That means whichever date it is the last day, on that day full and final settlement is done, his final check is made and handed over to him.
Where is it?
If that is you define in the system. I'll show you when we define the system. Then you have the final process date. Final process date means even after the employee has left, there might be some elements that you process. For example, overtime, bonus. Some companies, they have a rule that, you know, senior executive particularly, they will be paid bonuses every half year or every quarter. So in that quarter, he might have left, but as per the agreement with him, he will still be paid the bonus end of the quarter. So for that, you need the element to be processable even after he has left.
Repeat that again.
Sorry?
Can you repeat that?
What I'm saying is, final process date means till you put an end date on the employee's payroll, the employee can be processed for further payment. So that element will be processed when he has left the organization. Now, not all elements. His salary will not be processed. His HRA will not be processed. Only those items which are eligible, for example, bonus, maybe overtime, maybe, you know, shift allowances, maybe, you know, double time, extra time. These, the data comes after he has left.
So final process, after that nothing can be processed.
Nothing can be processed after the final process.
In end, we have to fill all these three, right?
Not, you have to choose. When you define an element, you have to choose that element will follow which rule, which of these rules.
So one of
normal elements, we choose last standard process date. For one or two elements, we will choose final process date. Okay. In exception cases. That usually client tells us which one will they process even after the employee is processed. Input value, every element has one or more than one input value. So what is an input value? Input value is anything that is required to process an element. Anything. Any information that you need to process the element. So suppose basic is 10,000, HRA is 50% of basic. So percentage will be a input value for HRA.
If for basic salary 10,000, what will be the input?
Basic salary 10%.
10,000 means what will be the input value?
You can have an amount, direct amount as an input value. So elements of earning, deduction, and other classifications except information have an input value called pay value by default created by the system. Information type of element will not have any input values by default. We need to add them as per our need. Pay value, remember, is used by payroll engine to put the final amount payable to the employee against that element. Like you said, suppose somebody's basic salary is $10,000, HRA is 50%. So on the HRA element, the payroll will do the calculation 50% of basic, that is 5,000, and put it on the HRA pay value. If the person works for 15 days, then that proration will also happen. So the pay value of the HRA will be 2,500, and the basic salary will also be for 15 days. That means 5,000. So the pay value will have basic salary 5,000 on the basic salary element and 2,500 on the HRA element.
Is the setup?
Sorry?
Input value is the setup, right?
Yes, input value is a setup that you have to define at the time of defining
the pay value, what is it?
Pay value is a one type of input value which is used for paying to the employee. Final amount that you pay to the employee. So, like out of this 10,000, if he is working 15 days, he will get 5,000. Pay value will show 5,000, but the amount will show as 10,000. Every month he's supposed to be paid 10,000. 1 month he might have worked 15 days.
So final amount is the pay value.
Final amount that is being paid to the employee.
It's a salary. Say it's a salary. Net salary.
Can you?
Can I say it is a net salary?
No, net salary is the combination of total earnings minus deduction.
So this is for one element.
Only one element.
Okay.
Each element will have a pay value.
Okay. So summary of pay value will be the final net salary.
Not pay value. That is like a balance, they call it. In the balance, they calculate, they add up all the earning elements. They do all the deduction elements, remove the taxes. Then they come up with the net salary. We can also define rules for each input value. For example, maximum, minimum, default, list of values, input validation formula to check values being entered by users. Okay. Now, remember, for an element, you have to define a eligibility rule. It is a must. Eligibility rule means it defines who are eligible for an element. All right.
So when you create element, you will define this rule.
Yes. It can be linked to work structures. Like you can say somebody in department HR will get this sales bonus. Somebody in sales department will get a sales bonus. Somebody in boiler department will get some benefit.
So you create bonus element and then link to only specific.
Yes. But when you link something, that is, system will always enforce it. There cannot be any exceptions. You cannot say that, I pay him. Okay, he has now moved to another department, we'll still pay him. There are a lot of companies who do that. They give an allowance, but they don't take it away. To allow all employees to get an element, we can define a blank eligibility rule, which ensures every employee is eligible for the element. So it is better to define an element with blank eligibility rule.
So every element is going to create the rule.
Yes. If an eligibility rule is not defined, one cannot assign an element to the employee. So if you go to another screen, is called element entries, where you assign the element to the employee. If you don't find the element, the first reason you should think is maybe the eligibility rule is not defined.
Even if it's a basic or HR, you should define it.
Yes. So eligibility rule is a must.
Okay.
Eligibility rule will also hold the costing or the accounting information. So this is basically the element design. Element will have input values, element will have eligibility rules. Elements will have formulas. An element will have balances. Element and input values will contribute towards the balances. Meaning that pay value that we were saying, na, if you are talking about total earnings, so salary pay value will contribute to the total salary amount.
What is formula?
Formula is those calculations. Like you said, 50% of basic. So you have to do a, write a small formula to say 50% of basic.
First formula.
Yeah, first formula. So this is the overall element design in short. Another thing that you need to define is the salary basis. Okay, this is also something which is mandatory. Salary basis describes the duration of the salary entered for an employee, whether it is monthly, weekly, annually, or hourly. Annualization factor will convert the entered amount into an annual figure. It links to the grades through the grade rate. It also links to the element and its input value into which the salary is entered in the element entry screen. Salary basis is linked to the employee in the change salary screen. Now, system will validate the entered amount against the grade rate for that grade. If the value is outside the lower and upper limits, then a warning message is displayed. If required, user can change the entered value or continue with the entered value. Meaning that message will be displayed. It is up to you whether you want to ignore it or not ignore it.
No, I don't understand.
A message is in shown to the user that the value you have entered is outside. You remember we defined grades. In the grade, we had said there will be a min and max.
Yeah.
So if the grade, if the salary that you are entering is outside the grade rate, min max.
Okay.
Then system will give a message saying.
Only what is it? Won't stop.
Sorry.
It's giving only warning message. It won't stop, right?
It won't stop. It is just a message, information message, warning. You can say. And you can choose to ignore it. Maybe you are intentionally giving him something more than his grade.
Okay.
So now we will go into the system and we will do this. We'll create an element called basic salary with an input value can be flat amount. We'll have an eligibility rule. Then we'll create a salary basis. We'll link it to the US annual grade rates. Then we'll assign the salary to the employee through the change salary screen and view the salary through the element entries. Okay.
Actually, you sent only this video recording only for sixth class. Remaining all I had to take from drive, right?
This is the drive that I am showing you.
No, you sent one attachment, one video with attachment, right?
Yeah. I'll send you all of them. All of them are there. I have sent all of them. Just check out. Otherwise, I will send you once again if you don't get it.
Yeah, please send me the video. I have only one video.
Did you get the URL for today's?
HCMA, yeah, yesterday he said, not today. Wait.
Today is Tuesday.
28th he sent, not before. Day before yesterday only he sent.
So from here, we'll first go to my client groups. Okay, over here, you will find, if you scroll down, there is show more. If we click on show more, and you can search for elements here. You get these elements. Okay. So we click on elements. So in this element, this is just like any other screen. Top part is search, bottom part is element name. If we want to create, we'll say plus. So we had said, as part of our practice, we will create an element called XX basic salary. XX is my name initial. Legislative group I will use as US. Primary standard earnings and standard. So now
we can process with salary with only one element, right?
Yeah. So here, one alliance, one element. Currency. Should every person automatically receive it? Keep it no. If you give it automatically, then everybody eligible gets it. Then it's a big pain if you have to change that element, because then you have to delete it from everyone. Earlier starting date, first standard earning date. This is that last latest entry date I was telling you the rules. Final close, last standard earning date, last standard process date. Usually last standard process date. At which
After that they can't process any element, anything.
Correct. This element, not anything. Not anything. Yeah. Only this element. It pertains to this element. This is at the assignment level. And element recur every, is it recurring, non-recurring? It will be paid every month, so it is recurring. Process element only once in each period.
There is standard rule. First, what is this? Employment level, assignment level, term level.
Assignment level is the assignment.
Term means?
Term means the terms that you have under assignment. You could have, like, you know, we have that work relationship terms, na? So it could be at that level or at the assignment level. Usually it is at the assignment level.
Have you ever come across a term level?
No. Usually we do it at the assignment level. Can a person have more than one entry? Can a person get more than one basic salary in a month? No. For overtime or maybe for double time, shift allowance, it will be yes. He can get more than once. Process and pay elements separately with other elements doesn't apply. This applies for bonus and other, you know, payments. What is the calculation rule? You can have different rules. So we are using a flat amount. Factor means multiple. Percentage means 50%, 30%, hours into rate.
No. What is factor?
Factor is multiple. Two times, three times. What is the default periodicity? That means you are going to enter it in monthly basis. How do you want the work units to be reported? Nothing special rules, subject to proration, yes or no. If yes, then you have to specify a proration group. On what basis you are going to do the proration?
So we have a separate proration here set up?
Yes, you can do that.
We will see proration or
This is how you do it, na?
Only this is the proration here.
Is this element subject to retroactive change?
Actually, in EBS, there is a separate concept, is the proration, right?
Yeah, they have derived it from there only.
So only these three columns only here proration.
In this element, is this element subject to retroactive? Retroactive means backdated changes. Okay. If you do yes, then again you will have to specify which retro element. So there would be some entry changes for the retro. FLSA is the Fair Labor Standards Act of US. This is basically overtime and all that. If you are working overtime, you are paid more.
It is only for US.
Correct. Oh, I forgot something. I should have changed the date. Usually, we keep it in the beginning of the year so that, you know, you will get the whole year to make entries. So, this is the review. Once you are done, you will say submit. Now, this element takes a few minutes. So, be patient. It will not happen immediately. It takes quite 5-10 minutes. There are a lot of formulas, additional elements that it creates for the US legislation.
What about tax and all, income tax and all?
Taxes and all, most of these are based on the legislation. So they are part of the legislation rules and they are included in the solution.
But it is there for US, right?
Yeah, US and some legislations are there, but not all.
How do you...
SP basic salary, here you have the status. You have to wait till it turns green. Yeah, you were saying something.
So can we will show about tax, right?
No, taxes we are not. Taxes is basically standard offering. So it's part of the standard solution itself. You don't have to do anything for the taxes.
So there is no setup, nothing?
Nothing.
So based on the registration, when we payroll, if we are getting 1,000, if you want to put 30%, it will deduct.
Yes, that it will deduct on its own based on the legislative rules.
No need to. If for example, there is some tax exemption coming from employee, what they will do?
So in that case, those would be captured as separate elements depending on how you have defined your elements. So suppose like in case of India, you have medical allowance where you can claim certain expenses as medical tax-free. So in that case, those you will have a separate way of capturing that information that you have claimed those as your expenses.
So that's an element only we are going to define.
Correct. Ultimately, everything here is an element. So once you understand the element, so whenever you need anything, all you need to do is define an element.
So now you are doing for US payroll. So when you are processing the payroll, you are telling that automatically tax will apply.
Taxes.
Okay, let's see when you process. We did not see that input entry and all.
It will come after this.
After this, okay.
Unless you create the element, you cannot get two input values. Thank you.
how we basically created a salary element, right? Basic salary element.
Correct.
This is only for we can attach this salary element to this only the US registration group employees.
Yes, this is for
US. Is there any link with the business unit? Nothing.
Anything? No, nothing. As of now, nothing.
Is there any option?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, option in the sense that eligibility rule is there. Wherever you can define an eligibility rule, that's the only one.
It's based on the grade.
Now it's completed. Okay. So see what Oracle does is behind the scene, it will go and create all these extra elements. This is for the US legislation. So we will deal only with our basic salary. So we go to basic salary, create edit.
So there is, we cannot control anything else in here.
No use also now, because those are for internal calculations of Oracle and we are not bothered about what it is doing. These are the input values that it has created on its own based on our choice. Okay. And at the bottom here, you have the element eligibility. If you click on it, then at the actions, you will have to create your element eligibility.
So next is element eligibility.
Yeah, element eligibility. Input value, it's already there, so nothing to do. Like you were asking, what are the, these are the ways in which you can link up. See, there is no, do you see business unit here? No.
Bargaining unit.
Legal employer, department, job, grade, all these can be used.
All this payroll under law, what is that?
SP, let's say just SP basic. Just name something and leave it blank and save it and submit it.
So if you choose a department job, then this element only applicable for that job, department.
Only for that job, only for that department.
So only that payroll like that.
Yes. It becomes very restrictive then.
So usually for organization, we don't do that, right?
Yeah.
For basic.
Yeah. Initially, now, these people, users will say, I want it for this job. I want it for that department. Then they will come back to you, say, oh, you know what? This guy, he doesn't work that department, but still gets it. Yeah. Why? Because 10 years ago, he used to work in that department. Now it's very easy to give something to an employee, but very difficult to take it away. Okay, so now our basic salary is done. We created, we went there, we checked the input value. We did that element eligibility, that's done. After this, next thing we'll define is our salary basis.
Where you will enter this basic amount and all?
I'll show you that next. salary basis. Okay. Salary basis. So when we go to salary basis, so here what we are defining, the frequency of payment. So here we'll create our salary basis. Again, we will say effective date, all of them leave it as 1st Jan. SP.
This is mandatory, right? Salary basis.
Yes, yes. Active. Salary basis type, keep it as amount determined by user. And frequency, what frequency? If it is monthly, calendar month or monthly, then system will multiply it by 12. So you are entering basic salary, you will enter as, let's say, 2000 dirhams. Annually, it will become dollars. So it will become $24,000. Element will be, like we said, SP basic.
So we are linking this.
Yes. And which input value? There were so many input values, right? So we'll choose the amount input value.
So if you choose pay value, you have to choose the other element and need to mention the percentage.
Correct. At salary basis, you will only link it with one. So this is the grade value. Once this is done, we'll say save and close. So you have linked the salary basis, you have linked it with your element and the grade. Next. We will go to person management. We'll now assign this to the employee. Do you have your employee? You had created one Sadiq, right?
Yeah, Sadiq Ali. QUE. UE.
I don't think it will come. It's gone probably. If it didn't come in SIDI,
it's caps all.
All caps, huh?
Sadiq space Ali. It's gone.
Okay. Now let's go to one which is in US. John Douglas. First, we will go to the salary. So this is the change salary. So currently he is getting this much. Oh, this is hourly salary. Okay. So we will propose a new salary.
No, if it is a new employee, what will happen?
Same way. You will go to that same salary, manage salary, and you will give him.
No, it will be blank, right?
Yes, it will be blank. Only thing is it will be blank. So let's say this is month. Let's give him from May. Promotion. And this is from healthcare. This salary basis, you can change to our salary basis. What happened? Different employer. But I think different employer.
So different
this is, no, yeah, the business unit is different. That legal employer is there, na?
Mm.
It's probably linked to the, but we didn't link it to the legal employer. It shouldn't matter. See, SP salary basis is not showing up. So we pick that. Now see this amount. Oh, there is no grade here. Okay. Suppose we give first, it doesn't have a grade.
No, what are you trying to do?
See, I gave him a huge amount, so the grade rate should have shown here. If we had a grade rate, na? Let me just check his assignment. See, the grade is blank here.
What they are doing now?
I'm giving him a grade. So I'm just loading this page one more time after populating the grade, change salary. See, now this grade is coming. Okay. Now we'll pick up the Sadiq, you can hear me?
Yeah, yeah. I'm here.
Okay. Now see, all this grade information is coming.
Yeah.
Mid max. This is the midpoint. So if I enter something more than what he's supposed to be getting, 3,500, you will see a message pop up.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is what it was saying over there, that if, you know, will it give you a message?
Now, what is the difference between this basic salary and the salary basis? Is a total salary including everything?
Salary basis is the frequency in which the payment will be done.
That is fine, but you are mentioning a salary.
That is what it is. That is what it is. Not it is fine. That is what it is. Salary basis means it is the frequency of payment.
Frequency of payment. I agree. Payment. This is why this mentioning salary amount here. What does it mean?
So means this is to be paid monthly amount. So that's why it is giving an annual figure of 42,000.
It's basically set net amount then.
Not net amount. Don't get confused. Is your basic salary in net amount the same in your salary pay slip?
No, no.
Then?
No, no. How I'm trying to do the basic salary, HRA and all.
So all those are different types of earnings.
Okay.
Together, you get total earnings. Then you get the total deduction.
So can I say
earnings minus deduction is your net earning?
Yes. Okay. But what is this in salary amount? I'm confused.
What?
This amount, the salary amount.
Basic. This is the basic salary amount. This is what you will get. Basic. Suppose you have a basic salary. This is what your basic salary is. On top of it, you will get HRA. On top of it,
it's only a basic salary.
Yes. Here it is only a basic salary.
So this will link to that element.
Correct.
But I can't see, where did you link that element?
Yes. We have linked already. When we define the salary basis, we link the element.
Okay.
So now, once I submit this, this is the proposed value, new value that is coming up. Do you want to continue? Say yes. Now to check this, you have to go to element entries. Once you go to element entries, you see this element entries here? You change the date. We entered it as of 5th of May.
Okay. From where you went to this element entries? Can you
here, show? Here on the side. Tax panel.
So you finished salary basis. Now we are into element entries.
Element entries. Correct. Now remember, the salary has to be approved before it can be paid. So right now it is default set to auto approval. Sometimes it takes a few minutes to get it approved. Pending approval.
So the salary is still pending approval.
It takes a few minutes. If it is auto approval, it will happen. Sometimes people keep removing these auto approvals, then it will. So this is now approved. See? You see this?
Yeah.
So this is approved now. So once you approve it.
Now only it's approved. Hello?
Yeah, now only it's approved. Correct.
What is this something already coming? This employee already linked?
Yeah, because this employee was already existing, na? And some of these maybe he's already enrolled in the vacation plan and stuff like that. Now, on this element, this salary that you have entered, that will come automatically. Other than that, if you want to enter any additional entries, this is the element entry screen.
Okay.
So you click on plus and you will be able to add any other element that you want. Suppose you want to put give him a bonus. So you have bonus direct, non-recurring. So you say continue.
New assignment number is coming. Will you have multiple assignments?
No, only one assignment. These are the input values. Okay. So for this particular element, which is bonus direct, this is the amount input value. This is the pay value. So whatever amount you will put here, you can process that and pay through the pay value finally.
When actually, this is one-time payment. Where you are mentioning this?
Sorry?
Basically, this element is one-time, right?
Yeah, this is non-recurring, so one-time.
So it's already defined. We have to just put
yeah,
that.
Yeah, it's already defined.
You chosen periodically. It means...
See, now this SP basic salary has come. So if I go back to 5th of...
No, actually when you done the salary, automatically it's coming here or you attach to this?
No, this will come automatically. If I do change salary, whatever is linked to your salary basis, that will come automatically.
Automatically to basic salary, so basic salary.
Others you have to manually add. Like I added this bonus direct, 10,000. Okay. That will have to be done manually. Understood?
Yeah, I got it. Is there any option to edit here?
Yes, you can click on... No, this you cannot edit here. This you can... See, this edit is disabled here.
Okay.
This salary, you can only edit in change salary, which is also called as salary proposal.
In case of promotion, what you will do?
Again, you will go there and give him a new salary.
Change salary. Okay.
If it is an element entry, you can come here and make the entry. It changes directly. You click on edit. Instead of 10,000.
You cannot add directly basic here. So that should come from salary.
Correct. So if I change it to 12,000, this will now become 12,000. See, now this has become 12,000. Got it?
Yeah.
So if you click on this SP salary basis, you will see the amount is getting populated here. Got it?
Yeah.
So this you should practice, and you know, so creating the element input value, eligibility rule, creating the salary basis, and this is the practice basically. Yeah.
Okay.
Element input value, eligibility rule, salary basis, link it to the US annual salary grade rates, and assign the salary to the change salary screen.
Okay.
Clear?
It's fine. Yeah. So leave and all will come in absence management. How do you link leave?
Yes, leave and all will come in absence management. Correct.
So what about